That our mayor's here. He's got a few words for us to say.
Well, in deference to the weather, the conditions we're in, and also Kathryn told me no more whereas. I'll just read the last paragraph of this proclamation, and it reads as follows. Now, therefore, be it resolved, I, James Perkins, Jr., mayor of the city of Selma, Alabama, and on behalf of the citizens of Selma, Alabama, on this occasion, proclaim June 1, 2008, as Kathryn Tucker Windham Day in the city of Selma, Alabama, and urge all citizens to join in this joyous occasion of honoring Kathryn Tucker Windham on her 90th birthday as an ordinary woman who is making extraordinary contributions to Selma, Alabama, and the world. Kathryn, God bless you.
Not too many whereas. Come cone.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
Now, does everybody know how to play the cone? All right, you need a comb, everybody should have a comb, and a piece of wax paper. You simply wrap that wax paper around that comb, and all of a sudden you have to raise your voice real high, especially the men now. Men, we can't be like, ooh, ain't gonna work. It's gotta be like an octave higher. Woo! Okay, so everybody's trying to, woo! Oh, that's pitiful. That is pitiful. We are so fortunate to have Dr. Mike Mahan and his jazz group from Shelby County with us, and they're going to help us to get the right tune every now and then on some of these songs. And we're delighted that we could. I thought it'd be very appropriate that the first song we do would be America the Beautiful, because we are proud of our nation. So let's have an introduction, please, sir. Here we go, two. Group of songs, including that one to do. The next one, she decided we need to do one. She'll be coming round the mountain. How many remember that one? Here we go.
It was a horrible year. I had 30 seventh graders in just me, and not a one of them wanted to come to Sunday school. And they would get so loud and so loud and calling to each other. They didn't care what their teacher was. The only way I could get a choir was to say, let's have a little prayer. Well, I never prayed as much in my life. Well, I asked one Sunday if any of them had ever played the cone. None of them had. So I went to Carter's Drug Company and I bought 30 cones and a roll of wax paper and I came back. That year we played the Methodist hymnal from first to last. I never tried to have another Sunday school there, and that's when the cone was started.
Thank you.
Meadows, church services I've attended, and was one of them when I had to be hustled out of the church. I was about three, and the shimmy was the popular dance. And it was denounced from every pulpit, every preacher, every Sunday, such like, if you shimmy, you cannot go to heaven. Unbeknownst to my parents, I put those and taught me to shimmy. And I was three and I was good. Well, only Thursday and I and Thursday's husband Ellie knew about my talent. We go down to Thursday's house and Ellie could get out his fiddle and he would fiddle in Thursday's dad and I would shimmy. The marvelous thing going on. Well, one Sunday at church I was sitting between my parents, as I always did at that church in Thomasville. The preacher announced we had a visiting musician from Birmingham. Miss Estelle Cuddy could come down, she was going to play the offertory. I didn't have an idea what an offertory was, I just took a place. As soon as Miss Annie, she was playing one of those upright pianos there, you know, we have them in all the churches. Always had flowers on top of them, a bowl of flowers on Sunday morning. And those flowers would just shake and shake, and she'd play the piano. But she was an enthusiastic player. She didn't waste any key. She played a lot. No matter what we were singing, she played all of them. And those bowls up there just shaking. Every Sunday I'd pray for it to fall off. And I'd just fall off. But anyhow, this Sunday when I was three, Miss Annie began to play the accompaniment with an visiting musician, reached down and picked up a violin and tucked it under her chin. And as soon as she did, I hopped up on the pew between my parents and announced in a loud voice, "I'll shimmy for you." And they hustled me out of the church. I don't like it. Well, I don't like it.
Very